This huge mural stands out like a beacon on a wall on Park Avenue above Sherbrooke Street. The Richards, Henri, number 16, taking a pass from his older brother, Maurice the Rocket. Their real-life exploits were larger than any mural. The Rocket, to Henri, to Dickie Moore, over to the Rocket. Great memories. And memories are all we'll have of Henri's tavern. Tomorrow, he's closing up. But today, as usual, he's getting ready for the lunch hour trade. This was a lot more than just a friendly place to have a beer and a tasty lunch that was easy on the budget. It has been a hockey shrine decorated with souvenirs of a magnificent hockey career. A marvelous mural on the rear wall depicts the Pocket Rocket in action. He was a mainstay of the Canadiens for 20 years and won 11 Stanley Cups, more than any other player ever. During hockey's most exciting era, the 50s, 60s, and 70s, he was one of the dominant players, a true superstar. In a wall case, the sweater he wore in his final game, the stick, the size 6.5 Tackleberry skates, and one of his all-star sweaters. On the ceiling, racks and racks of hockey sticks, a clear message from above, hockey is the true game here, and the prime source of conversation.
Wayne Gretzky is the best hockey player right now.
What about Montreal Canadiens?
Montreal Canadiens? Well, these days?
These days, yeah.
This week?
This week.
Well, I'll say...
Bobby Smith's
doing all right.
But all that happiness soon disappears when you talk to the regulars about the closing.
Bob, I'm coming here since he opened. When he bought that place, the first day he bought it, I came here. And since then, almost every day. I mean,
how are you feeling now that the place is not going to be here anymore?
I'm feeling very, very bad about that, because where am I going to go after? After 26 years, I come here every day, almost. And sometimes I get a party with Henry. I don't know what I'm going to do after.
So time has almost run out for the regulars in Henri Richard's bar, and for the many tourists who came from all over North America. Here's Montreal Gazette sports columnist Tim Burke.
Well, I think it's another sort of sad milestone in the history of Montreal. I mean, this is a great shrine of hockey. I think you know that you can't come in here that there isn't somebody from Saskatchewan or British Columbia making a bit of a pilgrimage. And the memorabilia, I mean, is unbelievable. One of the greatest sports organizations in history, and the only man ever to play on 11 Stanley Cup winners. And as far as I was concerned, and I covered him day after day, he was the greatest fellow and competitor I ever met in my life in any sport. So when a fellow like that withdraws from the public scene, and he'll be around, but he'll be a very private person from now on. It's a terrible loss to the city of Montreal.
Here's Bob, the last draft.
Thanks, Henri. Tell me, after being in business here for 26 years, why did you decide to sell?
Well, Bob, 26 years and 6 months, actually, to be exact. I got a couple of sons and the one that's working in city of Laval, and the other that been the last 3 years been working here. And they're not really interested. They want to go somewhere. They don't want to follow the tradition, I guess, and want to work somewhere else. They want to work in here right now. So my wife and I decided to sell.
Upholding a family tradition is something Henri values very deeply. He was only 19 when Sam Pollock brought him up from junior to the Canadien. He would be measured against his famous older brother. Maurice the Rocket was hockey's most explosive scorer and already a legend as a fearless competitor. They said Henri was too small at 5'7", 160 pounds, but he soon showed he could take it and give it out with the very best. He was a brilliant skater who could fly past defensemen with truly incredible speed. Those of us who watched him for 20 years remember him as much for his tremendous determination as for his great talent. Henri took 1,000 knockdowns, but he always got back up and headed for the net. It isn't just coincidence he scored two Stanley Cup winning goals, both of them on the road. This is Chicago Stadium, 1971. Late in the third period, it was 2-2. Henri streaked past Keith Magnuson and shot the puck over Tony Esposito. In his 17th season in the NHL, the wonderful skating ability had hardly diminished. That made it 3-2, Canadiens, and the Blackhawks never recovered. It was the 10th Stanley Cup for the Pocket Rocket. He also had the scars to prove that victory is never easily earned. Then, suddenly, it was over. Retirement. Maurice the Rocket was one of many who paid tribute to Henri for 20 marvelous years in the NHL. Now it's time to turn another page. Closing his bar means the end of a ritual.
As you know, I bought that 1960, and every year, win or lose, the team used to come to this place, and we had a little party, if you can call that a little party. It was a lot of beer.
All that is over now, along with signing thousands of autographs for hockey fans from all over North America. Is he going to miss meeting people and running a bar, something he's been doing for more than half his life?
Well, Bob, I guess that it's just like I was too with hockey. I want to retire the last 2 or 3 years. And I'm a guy that I don't look back, I look ahead, and I don't regret anything. It's every good thing's gonna come to an end, and this is it. I don't really feel sad. Of course, a little bit, but not that much. After I'm out of here, I'll be doing something else.
All these trophies and souvenirs have already been given to his children and his friends, and soon it will be time to go. As usual, Henri will do it quietly with grace.
Eh ben. Salut.
Salut.
Hello.
Amuse-toi.
Hello.
He says he never looks back, but on Christmas Eve, when he leaves his bar for the last time, Henri might just look back once. For Newswatch, I'm Bob McDevitt.